Welcome to Library Choice YouTube channel. Today's class, I'm going to be learning how to make this beautiful cowl drape neckline on the back. So we're going to be learning how to cut this together with a facing. So this is a requested tutorial from our Style Inspiration channel. It's a new channel we created where we share different style inspiration, and the link to the channel is going to be pinned on this video. So kindly check out the channel, watch this video, and enjoy. Okay, so to make this back cowl neckline, I need my basic bodice pattern. This is the back, and you need it without the zipper allowance because there's not going to be a zipper on this. So this is my neckline of 3 inches by 1 inch, my shoulder slope, and this is my dart. So now I'm going to cut off my shoulder slope, and we're going to be using one of the simplest methods to make this. There are several methods you can use to make your cowl pattern by introducing volume, and I have few of them on the channel already, but this one of the simplest methods. So after having my pattern like this, the first thing I'm going to do is to change the neckline. So I have my 3 inches by 1 inch regular neckline here, so I'm going to change this to like a kino neckline. So I'm increasing the neck width from 3 inches to 5 inches, as you can see, and then I'm going to increase the depth to about 2 to 3 inches as well. So now I'm going to redraw this, and this is going to be my new neckline. Okay, so you can cut this off so that we know what we're working with. So now after cutting this off, I have my waist dart here, so I'm going to be using this to introduce the volume. So like I said, there are several methods. You can actually draw some style lines across this area, and then you cut it so that you can spread it so that you have more volume on this, or you can just use this dart, so which is what I'm going to be using. So now you can see the center dart line that I have here. I'm just going to extend this upward like this, and then I'm going to cut off this dart. So cutting it just means you're going to slash it open, and then I'm going to slash through the new line that I have cut. Then I can now cut off the dart that I have. So this is the pattern that I have now, and then you can see that the dart is eliminated. So now to introduce this volume to form our cowl neckline, what I'm going to do now is to close this on the waistline. You can see the waist area now. I'm going to take them together like this, and then I'm going to spread as much as I want. Okay, you spread as much as you want to create the volume that you need. So if you don't want it to drip too much, you can just spread a little. If you want it to just really go, then you spread more. So this is how we're going to be spreading it. Now I'm going to bring in a fresh paper and then spread this on it. Okay, so I have my fresh paper here now. So I'm just going to place the side like this, and then I'm going to spread this smaller part. So if it's shifting, you can hold it down with your masking tape. Just make sure that this lower part is equal. So this is how much I'm going to spread this. So once you are okay with what you have, the spread you have, you're going to hold it down like I have done. So just for the sake of measurement, I think I spread by about 10 inches. So this is what I have now. So the next thing now is to connect this from the neckline. So depending on how draped down you want this to be. So from here, I'm just going to measure about, I think, 4 to 5 inches. Okay, depending on how low you want it to be. About 4 to 5 inches, basically. And then I'm going to bring in my ruler, and then connect from this neckline all the way down like this. Okay, so if you want it more, you just take it down a little bit more. So it's totally up to you and what you want. So I think I'm just going to leave it around here. So this should be about 5 inches, and then I'm going to connect like this. So this is the new pattern that I have now. this pattern is shifting, so I just want to hold this down. So now on this new pattern that I have, I'm trying to draw out the new shape that I have. So you can also use your tracing rule to achieve this. Okay, so after drawing it down, now drawing this pattern out, I can remove my original pattern. So this is my shoulder point, this is my armhole point. Okay, so now I'm going to remove this pattern. I can see the shape that I have. So here I'm just going to completely close this part. That's why I said the depth does not really matter, because I'm still going to work with what I want. So this is the new pattern that we have for our cow. So if you want to have like your facing together, all you just need to do now is to extend this now and cut out your facing. So you can extend this by 2 inches, 3 inches for your facing. So whatever it is that you have here now is going to be your facing. So when you want to cut the facing, you have to put it on fold by the neckline here. You're going to put it on fold before you cut out the facing that you need. So I'll go ahead now and cut this shape. Okay, so like I said, you can see that I have cut this part. So here I'm just going to put this on fold so that I can cut out the rest. Okay, so you can see. Then I'm going to cut my shoulder as well. Now you can open it up, you can see. So assuming I did not put it on through, this is how I would have cut it out, and then I would have had a little problem there. So here I'll just cut this, and this extension here is going to be my facing. So remember, this is your center back, so this part have to be cut on fold, because you're not going to have a zipper here. So you're just going to place this on your fabric. You can fold your fabric in bias form so that it can drip very well, and then this part is asked to be on fold, and then you cut out exactly what you have on this pattern. Okay, so this is my fabric. I can see I have folded my fabric on bias like this, just a little, and then this is the fold point. So I'm going to place it against the center back, which you have to put on fold. So here I'm just going to pin this down now and then cut out my shape. Okay, so I have cut it out now. I can see what it looks like. So now I'm going to remove my pin. So now all you just need to do is to cut your front pattern the same way, but make sure that you use the same neck width. Remember, you are going to sew it together on this shoulder, so it has to be the same. So the same 5 inches neck width that we use for the front is what you are going to use for the back. Is what you are going to use as the neck width for your front as well. And then you can now work, decide on the type of neck depth that you want to work with. So now this is what I have. Opening it out, this is what it looks like. So now for your facing, you just need to fold in this facing that you created. Okay, you just need to fold it in like this, and then this is what it's going to look like. So you can see the cows that we have formed at the center back. So depending on what you want, your facing can be longer like this than this. In fact, if you have enough fabric, just make it longer so that it's not going to be poking out anytime you're wearing it. So now I'll go ahead now and pin this on the mannequin so that you can see what it looks like. And once your drapes form like this, your waist is going to go back to normal. So you can see that the wig is not looking like a V shape. It's not looking funny as it was looking before. And you can see that the cowl that I have here is really dropping down, because I went really down when I was connecting my neckline. Okay, so you can see when I was connecting like this, I went down. So if you don't want it to drop this much, you can just go up. Remember, I still went down by five inches. That was after I have already used a 2 inches neck depth for my neckline. So now I'll go and pin this to the mannequin so that we can see what it looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks like on the mannequin, and you can see how much drape we have formed on our center back. So this is what it looks like. You just need to remember to make your front neckline as wide as this so that you'll be able to sew them together. And then you can see that the back is quite low, so if you don't want yours to be this low, so you make sure you don't extend your neck depth this long. I use around 5 inches. You can use 3 inches or 2 inches, and you can always try out on a spare fabric first before you work on your actual fabric. And then my pattern already has an allowance, so you can see the side seam allowance extending that way, so you have to take note of all of this. I hope you enjoyed making this beautiful tutorial with me. If you enjoyed it, let us know in the comment section. Like, comment, and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.